Hey, it's Max, the original Flowgrammer. I'm in the AI capital of the world, sunniest San Francisco. I'm gonna show you a really awesome new integration that we have inside of NNN. It's called AirTop. I'm joined by their co-founder and CEO, Amir, today.
Hey, Max, how are you doing?
Amir, what is AirTop and why did you build it?
AirTop is a web automation platform that allows you to automate anything humans can do online,
okay,
on any website, uh-huh, with just words.
So it's kind of like Puppeteer?
It's the next generation web automation, okay, platform. Okay. It means that you don't have to select DOM elements anymore, okay, and okay, you don't have to spend hours on writing scripts that will break every time the site changes.
Okay.
You can use natural language in order to automate action and extraction of data from website,
uh-huh,
and it will work regardless of changes in design of the page. And it can also connect, obviously, to the AI agent that you develop and connect the AI agent to the web to work autonomously.
That was gonna be my question. So what does this new NNN integration of AirTop, what does that mean for NNN users? What can we do now?
Yeah, this is fantastic because what NNN brings is obviously the integration with hundreds of SaaS application, but also the AI agent node,
uh-huh,
and the ability to add a human in the loop.
Okay.
So when you think about those agents, often you want to let them run their things, but have the final word.
Yeah.
Basically, make the final decision whether you want this to go live or not to go live, uh-huh, to buy the ticket or not to buy the ticket.
We're definitely buying the ticket. Can I try a dumbed down version?
Sure.
This lets my AI agent use the web, but like a human does, so
exactly,
like logging into stuff.
Exactly. And people build a range of things on this, from scrapers just to extract data, yep, from the web, all the ways to autonomous AI agent where they make decisions on the go as they run on what should be the next step.
How about we open up NNN?
Yes.
And AirTop, and would you mind showing me? Let's build something out.
Absolutely.
All right, fantastic.
So here is the automation and agents gallery that we have on our website. We support 4 development platform right now, make NNN, Python, and TypeScript, and a long list of potential use cases. And we're just going to pick one of those and maybe go with it. So all you have to do is click try automation. It will give you the URL here. If it requires authentication, you will need an AirTop profile that you can easily get in the profile section.
So this is your x.com account now. It knows how to log into it.
Exactly. Okay. AirTop allows you to grant your permission to your agent. So your agent can wake up in the middle of the night and do things on your behalf, extract information from website and take actions on websites that you allow it to do.
So there's a lot of these SaaS apps that don't have a separate billing email. So at the end of the month, I have to log in each time and go get the invoice. I can do that with AirTop.
It's actually a very common use cases. Accountants, okay, really love,
yeah,
that,
yeah, yeah,
because,
yeah,
it allows them to spread across all of those websites, extract the, yeah, invoices. We have a file download option,
gotcha,
and you can aggregate them all.
York, we're going to get this set up for you, brother. Don't worry. We're starting a session. So this is basically like kicking up a new web browser.
Exactly.
Okay.
Your cloud browser loads, and as you can see, it already loads with me authenticated. On the right side, you can see 2 windows. One is for you to put the natural language prompt. You don't have to mention the design, the colors, anything. Clear, simple description in English. For example, please extract 10 posts related to browser automation from the search results. And then there is a list of exactly what are the fields that I want to extract. If you want the results as JSON, you can decide that. There is a small flag here that will turn this on or off if you want the JSON.
Very cool. Mm-hmm.
And AI will generate the JSON for you, so you don't have to worry about this.
I've done some scraping before, and you're looking for IDs or classes, and then you see dynamic ones, and you know they're going to change. So if this DOM changes, since we're defining natural language, it's, yeah, going to be more resilient.
Yeah, we analyze the page on a visual, on a DOM level, and a text level. So it really independent and totally resilient to changes in the design. And then you can see the results at the end of it. And it came beautifully with, yeah, the first one is actually from Opera. You can see that,
uh-huh,
this is the,
yeah,
first one. They releases their browser. Congratulations, another browser with AI capabilities. This is good news. And the other thing that you can see is the number of credits, oh, that were used.
Okay, so you have metered pricing, basically.
Exactly.
So you pay for what you use.
Multiple packages, they start at $29,000.
Amir, I'm in the playground. I ran this, I tested it, I like it. How do I use this in NNN now so I can do this automatically?
Yeah, this is great. So let's go to the NNN side.
We just created a blank new workflow in NNN, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And now we can click on AirTop or search for AirTop and use the building blocks that we provide in order to build the automation or the agent. So what are those building blocks? They're about half and half between extraction of data and taking actions on websites. So for example, in extraction of data, we have things like query page, giving you answers to any kind of question, any data that you want to extract, or query page with pagination, where we handle automatically whether this is an infinite scroll or a next page and so on. Smart Script is just a clean download of the information. On the action side, we have things like click and type and fill a form, page download, page upload to automate actions on website. Other than that, it will allow you to create and terminate a session. If all you need is to get access to one page and extract data, you can simply add the query page and select automatically create session, it will handle everything, the creation of session, nice, termination. Nice. Mm-hmm. If your session is a bit longer, then you will start with create session, and you will initiate.
And you could have multiple pages, multiple queries, multiple
sessions. Exactly, and you will connect them through the session ID and window ID. So they're all connected to the same cloud browser.
Gotcha. So for the thing that we just created, I guess we could do it just from all one step, basically?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so in here we would x.com.
Exactly. Right? So if you want to do a page, you will take the URL and move it to here.
Uh-huh.
Then you will
take this prompt here.
We have so many of them now. Here it is. This is profile name. We will need that too. Uh-huh. This is the prompt.
Yeah.
And then you're just going to put a profile name that is authenticated for this service. If you want the JSON too, you will select add another field.
And there was that schema that we helped generate inside the playground as well.
Exactly.
Okay.
This is
the
schema. We're going to copy the schema, go back to N8N, paste it here. And now you have a service that is doing exactly the same thing within N8N.
This would be so much gymnastics in Puppeteer or something like that.
Yes. For many years, I suffered through the pains of using Selenium and Puppeteer and Playwright to create those things, and AI really changed things.
What I think is really cool is like this already could run every day and be useful, but again, within an expressions here, I could be changing some things in here. I could be changing this number or this here, very simply, be it form trigger, webhook, whatever. We now have web internet use inside of N8N as a step.
Exactly.
Fantastic.
And I think it substantially expands the use cases that N8N can support because it's not limited to APIs anymore.
And that's the thing. Some folks were able to do this, but again, the subset of folks that can stand up Puppeteer and want to stand up Puppeteer and maintain it and everything, you basically abstracted that all away and really emancipated a much wider group of folks to be able to use that.
Yeah.
Fantastic job, Amir.
Thank you so much.
We're running the workflow now. This is handling all those steps that we did in the studio, right? So it's booting up the browser. It's going to the URL we told it to. It's signing in through your account that's stored in AirTop. We're executing this prompt.
And it's actually scrolling down your feed or my feed until it will find 10 posts that are related to browser automation. So it may take a while because it goes through each one of those, making the decision whether it is relevant and then.
Hey, but no problem. You can be having a coffee or having a sleep while it's doing the hard work, right?
Exactly.
Easy.
So those automations work in the background most of the times and on a scheduled basis or on a trigger. So for example, I have automations that work every time a new customer signs in to get more information about the customer, send personalized information and so on. Here it is. Yeah.
Wow. Okay. We can see that we've pulled that all out there and it right now we're outputting a text, but you have a structured output
So
we could copy that in from the from the playground that we created in there as well.
Yes.
Wow. Fantastic. Gang, we've shown you the future now. These are all going to be available as templates as well. Go check out this awesome combination and show us what can you do now that you have AirTop and N8N. That's a challenge to you. Happy flow gramming. You are.